I don't know. I mean, I had no self-esteem. I had no hopes of, you know, anything getting better, no hopes of the future. I mean, I was ready to just let it all go. You know what I mean? In the winter of 2015, I had my first crisis. I went to the hospital. I came out of the hospital and I wasn't better. I actually declined from there and I started seeing a psychiatrist in Attleboro. I was diagnosed with general anxiety, depression, bipolar disorder too. And she recommended me for Pathways. The first time I went, like I said, you know, I wasn't sober. The second time I went, I'm sorry, am I answering the question?
Yeah.
Okay. The hardest point in time for me wasn't, I was sober, but it was when my daughter didn't want to talk to me. And she's my motivation, you know, for everything. Like what I do, I do it because I want her to be proud of me. I want to be somebody that she looks up to. Such a dark time, you know, I couldn't sleep it good at night. So then I would try to sleep during the day because I didn't want to be awake, but then I would have nightmares about losing her forever. It was just, it was a really dark time. I had gotten an OUI, and that was the point where I realized, okay, I need to make changes and I need to get help. The nurse practitioner at my med provider's office, she had been telling me that I should do DBT intensive for a long time. And at that point, I was willing to try anything. Learning how to handle my emotions, how to prepare myself for emotions that might possibly come up. You know, trying to evaluate whether how I'm feeling really fits with what's going on, because I tend to overreact, I tend to overthink, and you know, focusing on what the facts of the situation is and things like that are really, really what helps me, you know, stay focused. I graduated from DBT from Pathways and I started going to school, and Andy reached out to me and he said, you know, we're starting this consumer advisory board and your name came up. It's really, it's very flattering to hear, you know, that they have that much faith in me. It's pretty awesome because they're amazing people. So the advisory council, they asked what we think could be improved on with healthcare and mental health care and things like that. I want to show people that, you know, it's going to get better and it can get better. You just have to keep trying. You know what I mean? Just keep putting one foot in front of the other. Don't be ashamed. Don't be afraid to, you know, to tell somebody, because they've really heard everything. If the providers you have right now are not helping you, then find somebody who's going to help. Because providers, not only do you need, you know, you need to have the determination to get better, you need to have the right team. I told them when I left, you know, they saved my life. They really did. I don't really know what I could say about them. It's really.
Are you in touch with your daughter now?
Yeah, she lives with me now. It was a dark few months. My whole life I've kind of struggled with depression and things like that, and then when it got really bad I just had like no hope whatsoever. But now I feel like I kind of almost feel like there's almost nothing that I can't do if it's something that I want, you know what I mean? I do feel like I have so many possibilities, like there's just so much that I can do, so much that I want to do, you know what I mean?